Welcome to it, ladies and gentlemen. This is the definitive yo-yo. Let me ask you a question. Think we can support a 24-hour yo-yo streaming service? Yeah, I don't think so either. Today we are featuring the Yoyorecreation Valkerie. And there's been some changes. I don't know if you've noticed, but we're going to dive right in. We can't talk about the Valkerie without talking about the Dropnir. If you've been in the game any length of time, you already know about its storied history. Beginning in June of 2013, the Dropnir, for several years, has been the preeminent competition yo-yo. The gold standard? Well, maybe. But it's not to everyone's liking. And, let's be honest, modern standards have made the Dropnir a little old-fashioned. Despite this, the Dropnir's abilities are without question. It is best known for its neutral play and its powerful spin, due in large part to those bleeding edge rims. Here we have members of the Yoyorecreation team making the brand look pretty tasty. Yoyorecreation and the Dropnir certainly were not the first to employ this design, but it did popularize the form factor. In the years to follow, many brands have taken the Dropnir aesthetic and used it for their own purposes. Some to greater or lesser effect, but most are pretty good. I don't know if you've noticed, but recently the Valkerie has gone the furthest to forge its own identity apart from the Dropnir. First released in 2015, it was kind of a clone of the Dropnir. But let's check these optics and you'll notice that there are flared rims. Also, it's down from that $240 price tag that came out in 2013, down to a more comfortable $165. And you can get this for like $100 or $150 on the BST. But let's check the stats. The numbers paint a very similar picture to the Dropnir, but the Valkerie is a very different yo-yo, especially since the refresh. Our refresh also includes a less baroque, more modest, and elegant engraving. Officially, the word is the Dropnir is made for competition-level players, while the Valkerie is made for a wider audience without losing any of the performance. Here we have the Valkerie presented as it was in 2013. Very Dropnir-esque in its appearance. I can't speak about this older aesthetic, but what I will say is that these new flare rims translate to a weighty presence and a solid, comfortable, yet smallish throw. And I didn't notice until I had it in hand, they didn't flare the rims out, but they brought the body in. This creates a tighter center of gravity, making the rims hit harder in play. We'll speak on that in the play section. But I was surprised to see that it does sit in the same footprint as the Dropnir. It's just engineered a little differently. And I wish I would have seen this greenish yellow out in the field, because I would have got it. With this refresh, I'm wondering if we'll see a change in the sick tier, which was also emphasizing powerful rims. Here it is next to a Dropnir-esque type yo-yo, the Edelus. We'll do a little comparison in 1 second. To the uninitiated, these look pretty similar, but for those of us that are in the know, it's like night and day, which we'll discuss coming up. To be a bit more objective, I wanted to throw this thing against the Edelus, which is the closest thing I have to a Dropnir. The Edelus plays fast and neutral, is an excellent competitor. The binds are tight, it definitely has power and is speedy. It's maneuverable and has good acceleration. And I would say that the personality puts agility over aggression. I love the Edelus. And what drew me in was that deep violet against the black. However, its play plays exactly like I think it should. The way you think a yo-yo like this will feel. there's not many surprises. You just kind of know what you're getting, and there's a comfort in that. Enjoy pulling this out the case, but the feeling was pretty familiar. And yet, when we compare it to the Valkerie, the Valkerie is night and day. Let's just put it like that. Since I bought it new, Yoyo Recreation's reputation is well preserved here. But in a straight-on comparison, this thing is way more powerful than the Edelus. And interestingly, that flare rims and different body style makes it catchable beyond belief. Its main attribute is how powerful it is, but it doesn't skimp in the other departments either. There is, however, just the smallest amount of hesitation, and that's only because you're dealing with a lot of power, so changing planes and all that other stuff is not quite exactly what it's going to be. Do I prefer this over the drop near? Oh, yes. I probably will never be getting rid of this yo-yo, even as I develop some more tricks in my repertoire. I must admit, I'm deeply impressed. Yoyo Recreation took an already established design and supercharged it, making something very noteworthy. And that's the review, but check out what we get into for next time. Yoyo Recreation isn't the only company innovating. We're going to have a look at what some call G-Square's best yo-yo of 2021. Click the like button and subscribe so you don't miss out. All right, y'all. I'm Simply Mike. This has been the Yoyo Recreation Valkerie Review. And I will catch you guys in the next one. Aight. Aight.